Hi, I'm Tom Sullivan here in my Tom Sullivan Movie Memorabilia Museum and Art Print Gallery. I got to keep my props from Evil Dead in lieu of being paid, so here they are on display. For example, here is the Betsy Baker leg, the Linda leg that got stabbed with the pencil by Cheryl in Evil Dead.
Oh, yeah.
I hollowed out the other side and put a blood balloon in there, and then when Cheryl ran the pencil in, the clever effects guy, me, forgot that rubber's going to seal around the pencil. So she stabs the pencil and Sam goes, "Where's the blood? I got to see blood. Grind it." And she, that's what she did, and that's what's in the movie. That's why it's so painful to watch. Here's the Kandarian dagger from Evil Dead 2, recently refurbished. These things get beat up over the years. The original Book of the Dead from Evil Dead.
Oh, nice.
Oh, yes.
Was it the same one that was used in Jason Goes to Hell?
No, that was a copy from Evil Dead 2.
Oh.
And done interestingly without my knowledge, permission, compensation, or credit. That's Hollywood for you, huh?
Yeah.
Here's the Evil Dead 2, Book of the Dead. One of them that comes in, flies in the very beginning. It was written by the Dark Ones.
Oh, yeah. And,
as soon as this book comes fluttering in and then stops, and as soon as it stopped, I substituted it with this one, which has ball and socket joints. It had a rubber cover over it. So this is the one that comes alive, opens its mouth, and you zoom inside, and the ghosts come at you. Here's the gloves from the end of Evil Dead 1. That I'm wearing those when they burst out of people throwing guts in the audience.
Right.
As the effects guy, I thought it was important to throw intestines in the audience's lap. Let's see. Here's the necklace from Evil Dead 2. Yeah. In the second box I made for Evil Dead 1, if you notice, the covers kind of change from shot to shot because they lost the first one almost immediately, and I couldn't quite remember exactly what it looked like. Here's some masks from Evil Dead. Ted Raimi wore this one for one shot in the finale when he was fake shimping for Ellen. You guys know about the fake shimp term?
Yeah.
It's in the credits. When you're low-budget films, when actors aren't available, you grab somebody else and try to dress them up
put
as best you can. And the term fake shimp comes from the Three Stooges. When Shemp Howard died during the middle of a Three Stooges short, they found somebody who didn't look anything like him, put him in a shimp wig, put him in his coat, and come on, Shemp! And you see Shemp going, I need to waste this film a little bit. Here's Henrietta's head from Evil Dead 2. This pops up. This was sculpted by Mike Tursick. He went on to sculpt the maquette and much of the T-Rex for Jurassic Park. The guy is off the scale. I'm not kidding. Sadly, at the time,
in
the fruit cellar, sadly, this was done before they had put Ted Raimi in the Henrietta makeup. And he looked radically different, but it's a testament to Mike's skill. Here's various masks. Here's Scotty's mask from Evil Dead, one of Cheryl's masks. These are Shelly masks. This was a fake shemp one. I'm not even sure we ever used that. This one on Scotty's wrist. It was our Thanksgiving turkey bone. That was after he's come back after being ravaged by the woods.
I love the shot of his leg.
Oh, yeah.
His
right.
Leg? That was amazing.
Help me! Help me, Dad! Cheryl was right. We're all gonna die here.
And Ellen's, Cheryl's gloves. Here's the Flying Deadite from Evil Dead. It's a stop-motion model.
And this is all original stuff?
It's all original stuff.
Claymation and stuff?
Yes. Clay animation. Technically, claymation is a copyrighted or a trademark term. And but clay animation is what I did.
And you worked on Evil Dead 2 also?
All three of them.
Oh, so you worked with Bill Moseley.
Well, I wasn't there on the set for Evil Dead 3, for Army of Darkness. But, I contributed.
Well, thank
and
you
I'm
very
in the
much.
Credits. Thank you very much.
I'm Sullivan.
Thanks, guys.
This is awesome. Thank you.